Today, we're going to go over adding authentication to an Astro site. Now, you'll see here on my screen, I have a simple website and it's hosted on Vercel. And I'm going to log in with one of my email accounts and I'll click sign in. As you can see here, I'm signed in. This is a protected page. I can write my name and a message and submit it to a guest book, or I can sign out. And let's go back to the first page here. Make sure we can see everything. I'm going to click sign out and it will sign me out and it's going to ask me to sign in. I also have enabled GitHub login, so you can log in with your GitHub account. And I wanted to show you the process of setting this up. So in this video, we're going to set this up and take a look at it. One of the things that I'll mention right off the top is Astro recently announced that they're building something called Astro Studio. And what I think it's going to be is something similar to Supabase, where you can have database and you can work with data that's on a server. They describe on the landing page that they're going to provide a free tier. And it looks like this is the first paid service that they will provide. The reason I'm mentioning this is the Astro team has been really good at using user feedback. So I'm sure they're taking this stuff into account. So in a couple of months, it might be easier to build something like this with Astro Studio. We'll just have to wait and see what they come up with. But I just wanted to mention that. And if you're interested in this product or learning more, go to studio.astro.build. You can sign up for a wait list and potentially get into the early testing. But this video more or less is going to be based off of this repository, which I'll link below. It's called Astro Supabase. And it's actually by one of the Astro maintainers. We can check his profile here. He actually contributes code to Astro. So you'll see there's a bunch of different Astro repositories. And it's a really solid repository. So shout out to him. I'm basing this off of, like I said, this repository. So we can just fork it and we'll take a look at some of the information here. There's overlap between this document and this repository. I would bet that Kevin is the actual writer for this document, but it kind of goes through and explains what things should be where. And I'm just kind of going through this document and the code at the same time. The readme's kind of leaves something to be desired, but you can use that along with this document, which I'll also link below, to kind of get an understanding of what's actually happening here. So if you want to skip the next few minutes of this video and me rambling on about how this code works, and you just want a project using authentication with very little setup, just fork this repository, get the information that you need from Supabase, the environment variables, host it on Vercel, and that should be it. You don't really need to hear what I'm going to be talking about, but in case you do, here we go. So we need three things to get started here. We need an Astro website. We need a Vercel account because we're going to use the Vercel SSR adapter. And then we need a Supabase account. All of these things are free. You can sign up for free and start using them right away. So if I go to supabase.com/dashboard, it's going to show me my projects. For this one, I'm using Astro Auth as the project. And you'll see here, I just set it up. It's going to give me an API key and a project URL. And if you clone this repository, you'll see that there are the environment variable example. So what you want to do is go to the .env.example file and copy this exactly because you want to make sure that these values match completely. And you want to create a new file in the root of the project called .env and then paste in these values that you get at the project dashboard. And that will allow you to connect your Supabase account with your Astro project. So here, this document goes over it as well. Since we're using TypeScript, we want to make sure that we know what types these are using. So here is a file called env.d.ts. This is basically just saying we're working with strings for our environment variable files. And you'll see on the left, they'll show where these files need to be. They're both in the source directory. Next, we need to install the Supabase dependency. So you can run this in your terminal, npm install at supabase/supabase-js. This is going to add the required Supabase package. And then we want to go to our source directory. We want to go to a lib folder. So here we're just importing the environment variables to the supabase.ts. So this is going to allow Supabase to make sure that the environment variables match for your project. So next we go into auth. That's going to be within the pages API folder. We have a few files here. We have sign in, sign out, and register. The register file is where the bulk of the code is going to live. This is allowing the user to sign up. So we're going to import Supabase. We're going to import API route. We're going to take some form data, in this case, an email and a password to register the user. And we can test that out, actually. So this authentication doesn't live within like a traditional database, like the tab above it. That's going to be its own thing. And here we'll see the users that are signed up. I have Bob2 at AOL. Let's try Bob3 at AOL. So we need to make sure we're on the register page. So there's a sign-in page if you already have an account, but there's also a register page. And we're going to do Bob3 at AOL. We're going to register Bob. We're going to use this password here and click register. And it's going to send an email to Bob3. And we can verify that if we go back to the Supabase tab, it's saying waiting for verification, Bob3 at AOL. To show you what it actually looks like, let's register my other email here. We have a confirm your sign up from Supabase. Click the link. Let's sign in here. All right, cool. And we're signed in. It sees our email and it says this is a protected page. And here's our email in Supabase. So that's how the registration form works. It's just going to take the email and password and send it to Supabase. The sign in page is going to work in a similar way. If your email is linked to GitHub, we show a button that says you can log in with GitHub, but we'll go through that later. And the sign out basically just deletes the cookie, and you are no longer logged in once that cookie is deleted. And then they go through just adding the different pages. This is just the Astro pages, so this is just the markup for these pages. So if you want to add OAuth, which is logging in with like your GitHub account or your Google account, they go through the steps as well. Here, you need to add a auth flow type, and you need a callback TypeScript file, which is right here. This is going to log you in using exchange code for session. So it's going to see if you have GitHub auth that you should be logged in with that email. And I'll show you where to get that code. You do need a auth token from GitHub. So let's go through that process. So you go to your settings in your GitHub profile. So you just do this. You click your little picture and you go to settings. You want to scroll all the way down to developer settings. And then you go to OAuth apps. And here you'll see a button that says new OAuth app. Here you name your application. You provide it with a URL. So this is pretty important. Once the app is loaded, you need to update this. Like say you host it on Vercel or something. You want to update that. And then the callback URL you get from Supabase, which you can find in authentication, providers. You want to toggle this on the GitHub and it should give you the information. Yeah, here you go. So here's the callback URL, my client ID, and my secret. These all need to go to GitHub in this new OAuth application and you register it and it will activate it so you can sign in with your GitHub account. So here at the bottom of that of this document, they actually link the page. So here it is linked. I'll put this, the live preview below, and then I'll obviously the code repo as well. This works. So sign in. I'm signed in. I wrote Bob hello here. Do Bob again. Nice repo and submit. There it is. I can sign out. I can register. This one, they have Google turned on. You can do that if you want. I didn't want to do that step. But this is the base of how to add authorization to an Astro site. So you can start using it with dashboards or CRUD app, anything like that with user logins and user accounts. So I hope this was helpful. All this stuff will be linked below. You should definitely fork this repo. It's an easy way to get started. You just need to provide the information from your Supabase account, from the project. And then if you want to go the extra step and allow people to use your GitHub authorization, you need to go to github.com/settings/developers and add a new OAuth app. And that will give you the information that you need for that portion. So I hope this was helpful for the people asking or requesting for authorization within Astro videos. Like I said, it might get easier in a few months once they release Astro Studio. But until then, this is a great way to have user logins and user accounts on an application using Astro. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.